electricity is a significant hazard, and that can have significant consequences, often fatality, when things go wrong.
If you were to take a step out of the procedure or human error was to creep into play, there could be a large incident. So we had to eliminate that risk.
We wanted to keep the solution as simple as we could. You can physically see the lock is there. You've got the key, you know in the back of your mind it's got to be off.
We've gone that one step further to complement the new equipment, so to eliminate the risk of human error. My background is with the UK Health and Safety Regulator in their high hazard division as a specialist electrical inspector. My passion is for electrical engineering and in particular for electrical safety. At Ince, we take our electricity into site at 33,000 volts and we transform that down to 11,000 volts for distribution across the site. So quite soon after I joined CF, we were changing all of the switchgear associated with that.
The switchgear had been here since the site was built, and we wanted to replace it with a safer, more efficient system.
Switchgear is basically the equipment which switches the electrical energy on and off. So if we're working on the equipment, it's always important to not only de-energise the circuits, but also put them into earth. The idea behind that is if the circuit were to come alive for whatever reason, it would instantly dissipate the energy. So if there's anybody working on that circuit at the time, they'd be safe.
There's lots of maintenance that we carry out on a weekly basis with the switchgear. So there are various steps we have to take in these isolation processes. We've got 20 substations on site. Every one of them has two supplies. So even when we isolate at the normal supply to it, we've got a potential for another supply to it as well.
You could quite easily have one feed on, one feed off. And if you do something in the wrong order, something becomes live that shouldn't be live.
We run step-by-step switching procedures. It's not just step-by-step, it's step-by-step in this order. We used to just rely on ourselves, our training, our competency, our procedures.
You can do the right steps, but you've got to do it in the right order. You try and do it the wrong way, you're looking at a major incident, like a huge arc flash.
And a lot of the electrical incidents that happen when the root cause analysis has been done had come back to human error. So there's a lot of work going on in understanding human error analysis. We wanted to go one step further to complement the switchgear to eliminate the risk of human error. Even the newer switchgear that you can buy out there still relies on humans to operate it properly. So we took stock and as a team said, is there anything we can do differently? Can we engineer out the possibility of doing these steps in the wrong order?
Now we've got these mechanical interlocks, so you've got to do the switching schedules in the right order. You try and do it the wrong way, you physically can't. There's a bit of the metal there stopping you doing it.
So you have a number of these trap key interlocks on the upstream switchgear and the downstream switchgears, but they're only one key. So the key has to move from place to place along the way. Otherwise the interlock gets in your way and can only be released out of your way when you're in the right position for it to be removed.
We're just putting a mechanical interlock into the switchgear procedure so you can't actually miss an important step. We went out to various different manufacturers to see which ones could offer us the best solution. Every circuit interlock was a handmade solution, so it was like a puzzle to solve it. It was a lengthy process.
It took a lot of head scratching really to try and fit the new locks onto the older switch gear. Myself and Lee spent a lot of time to find the best solution. At the end of the day, we wanted to keep it as simple as we could. You can physically see the lock is there. You've got the key, it's got to be off.
With this initiative, we challenged the norms and we come up with an engineering solution to take out that possibility of human error. It is a purely mechanical solution to a significant electrical problem.
Previously, you pause before you switch this gear, make sure you're on the right one, it's definitely off. But now it's just an added peace of mind. It's great for adding more confidence.
Generally, when I talk to peers, I don't know of anywhere where they've actually installed this level of interlocking to prevent human error. Really, really simple to operate, maintenance free, and totally eliminates the possibility of human error in carrying out these specific operations on our distribution system.
This is certainly a solution that could be used industry wide. A lot of thought goes into the process, but once that's done, it's keeping people safe for many years to come. So it's a worthwhile exercise.
It's not so much the new equipment that's available, but actually the newer ways of thinking. We're proud of the solution we've come up with. At CF, we do it safe.
At CF, we do it right.
At CF Ince, we do it right.